RAF Dawes Hill, a Ministry of Defence site located near High Wycombe in Buckinghamshire. American military forces were first stationed at High Wycombe in 1942, shortly after the United States' formal entrance into the Second World War. Wycombe Abbey School was on the land that would become the American base. The school was given 3 weeks to find new facilities. A new underground headquarters, codenamed Pine Tree, was built in 11 months, with a cost of £250,000. The whole bunker was built within a bunker. This was to absorb the shockwave from a nearby explosion. It also had a two-level observation gallery and operation room. This was the nerve center for the United States Army Air Force European bombing campaign in World War II. It had direct links to the 8th Air Force Fighter Squadron at Bushy Hall. During the Cold War, the United States Air Force utilized sites in the UK due to the threat of attack from the Soviet Union. At RAF Dawes Hill, 70 new buildings were built, and the bunker was fitted out for atomic protection. This was to become the Strategic Air Command's UK headquarters. Between 1986 and 1989, the bunker was completely refurbished, decontamination room was added to the entrance, the three ventilation shafts were strengthened with concrete, the two-level gallery and operations room was floored over. This was to make more space. The United States Strategic Air Command 7th Air Division had its main European planning and operations center located in the bunker. This was responsible for organizing nuclear attacks against the Soviet Union. As the Cold War progressed, presence at the base slowly decreased. RAF Dawes Hill was deactivated in May 1993. Plans to redevelop the site for housing initially included proposals to demolish the bunker. These were submitted to Wycombe District Council in 2012 by the Ministry of Defence. They are still in motion, alongside proposals to create more than 400 new homes in the area, which has been met with opposition from residents. The bunker was given a Grade 2 listing, protecting this important historical site from what would have been its inevitable demise. So this week, folks, no infiltration, none of that jazz. This was an organised trip that we paid for. Let's check this thing out, folks. Let's go.
Telephone. Looks like an ammo box, isn't it? Yeah. I've never seen them before. Bulletproof.
Inside.
It's always nice to see them, isn't it? You go.
It's a good couple of inches.
I did bring back trainers left in the hallway.
Oh, that's a big toy. Bloody hell. It's not.
Is there any chance of getting a selfie with you lot?
Well, sure, we'll be. At the end, I think we'll do that through, folks.
Are you videoing?
I'm going to try.
See how we go.
Don't press the button.
Yeah.
Right. They
have
doors,
haven't they? Cool, they are.
Oh, it's alright.
No, seen that before, haven't we?
In the reverse. It's quite good, isn't it?
It's very good.
All the numbers different to quite a lot different to Brino, this, isn't it?
Yeah. Bloody hell. Right, cheers. Oh, what's that step there, folks? This reminds me of Greenham Common.
It's all standing still, isn't it?
Yeah. That's the hooks. God, it's small in here.
I keep walking into people with that website.
These I call the sweet Greenham.
Isn't that nice?
English.
Wow.
American. But they were in one unit, if I remember.
Yeah.
I think we're being called.
Are we?
Yeah. Cool, folks.
You're basically that as a way in, and then you've got another room that looks like that one.
All right.
You're
looking
there?
I'm lost.
Oh, yes, like a locker room. Wow, quite smells all right in here, doesn't it?
Sorry,
mate. Mad, isn't it?
Of them.
Oh yeah, that's some better days, isn't it?
I'm not poking your fingers in there.
No. Duct tape. What's that? It does, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, we'll find that out in a bit.
All right.
Story.
What's that?
Door seals, knife edge.
Right, I've got to watch my step, because the last few videos I've fallen
right,
over.
Step here.
Right, cheers. Thank you. Duck?
Duck.
Where's the duck?
Sewage storage.
You feel the breeze,
it's all the air intake.
Yeah, isn't it?
You can feel the breeze come down.
Well, that's sewage storage, man.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Right, cheers.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Cheers, mate.
We're putting water storage next to it, sewage.
Nice. Hopefully that's not drinking water. Bits and bobs in there. I've seen that door before. Where have I seen that mechanism? No, on the bit here. I've seen that before somewhere.
Step. Head.
Oh.
Step.
Oh, it's a bit crusty, isn't it?
Oh, a bit crusty here, actually.
Look at that. Probably it's just for ventilation, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, cheers.
Watch these bits that stick out.
Head, look at that, that's quite good. It's like Halloween, isn't it? Whoa!
Step.
What's that?
Fuses. Size of that cable in it.
Yeah. Mad, isn't it?
On.
Step.
Righty old steps there. Cool though. Wow.
Oh crap, look at the roof.
Oh, there's a yeah. Oh, cool.
Winching. Bloody hell.
Look at it.
Goes right up.
It's even higher. You see it through there.
Jesus. Yeah. It is. Oh, Shell. 86. Classic. Slope. Look at these things.
Water-filled gauges.
Didn't accept. Yeah, cheers. Oh, that feels a bit spongy. Cheers. Step there, folks.
It's also how they got around the corner. Before they locked it up there, that winching place. There was a winch at the top, and you could lower all of those sewage tanks and all those gas filters down to here, and then have the man down the short distance down the corridor rather than
down on those steps. Was it the Americans actually build? No, British contractors. So McAlpine's got the contract for all of the hardware and all of this plant equipment.
Yes,
don't buy a Lenser.
Don't buy a Lenser. Well.
Did you understand that's where all the equipment came
from? Right. Well, they just capped it off. Oh, is it? Look at that. Mad, isn't it? Step, right, ramp. What's that, Chris?
How far away? It's in the field. Swim around.
Oh, yeah. Bloody hell.
What? Same that side? Yeah, I can see that.
That's mad, isn't it?
The airflow is coming through.
I want to go up there.
It's a lot of work, but yeah.
What's that?
Something's been. You see that?
That's like a little drain. Hmm.
Step.
Step. Oh, there's a lot of steps, isn't there? Wow, they're big cables.
Dude, look at that.
You want to try the Conker?
Right. I don't think we should try them. See that up there, that one for you?
That old classic chair.
Ian, have you seen this?
What's that?
All the way along, it's a 1985 electric cable.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Like the traffic in your home.
Wow.
600 to 1,000 volt. Yeah.
Jesus.
I can imagine that.
Step there, folks. Look at the, you see the padlocks on those,
Yeah.
That's good,
isn't it? Looks like you're up here and over that.
Right.
You missed that bit out.
What, those transformers?
Yeah, you can miss the transformers out from down the side. I can't get the size of the cables,
well, put your hand next to it, Chris.
It's just, yeah. That's one of the biggest cables I've ever seen.
Look at that. Bloody hell.
Wow. Look at that earth thing, that copper up there.
Yeah, I see that.
How long was
it? That's it, Pete, come
on. No, no step
yet. Thank you. Yeah. There he is, folks.
That was brilliant. I enjoyed it.
That's good, isn't it?
Oh, we haven't even started yet.
Ain't we?
That's where we went in.
It's a big old door, Chris.
I like how it sort of shuts.
You what?
Feel like going.
Does it?
Shuts, yeah.
You are not locked in.
That's good to know. To be honest, I'd rather be locked in.
Now it's on the floor.
It's got a red light on that.
There you go.
Is it?
No, that
would be on the
block. No.
Yeah.
Radio frequency interference filter. Whatever that is.
Oh, right. Some sort of security, what do you reckon? Yeah, that's proper like 1980, isn't it?
Yeah, just the smell of that.
It's got a combination lock.
It smells more bunkery now.
Toilets. Where is it? This way?
Now then, the usages of the various rooms in the bunker, unfortunately for the most part, are a bit of a mystery. Sometimes there are signs on the doors which give a clue. But again, the bunker had three periods of history, as we know, World War II, the early Cold War, and then the Reagan era, later Cold War. And with each generation, different people would have used different rooms for different purposes. And certainly in the Reagan era, they would have put partitions in and created different rooms. And you can see that over there where you've got a fairly modern partition wall across there. So we don't always know what each room was used for. The signs, as I say, give us some clues. And here on this door, it says danger of asphyxiation, Halong 1301 fire protected area. So clearly lots of expensive computer equipment in here. And if there was a fire, then the Halong systems would come into play. The room is flooded with halon gas, pushes out all the oxygen, the fire goes out, great. Likewise, all the people in here would be similarly extinguished because this would be an oxygen-free environment. And it gives you an indication of the Americans' priorities in terms of kit versus people. Next to us, we've got more black boxes, top secret black boxes. This is part of the Tempest system. And Tempest is an ongoing operation against emission security, so it's part of MSEC. It's all about protecting against eavesdropping. How it works, I'm afraid I don't know. There may be other people in the room that know better than I. Tempest is actually an acronym for a very clumsy telecommunications electronics materials protected from emanating spurious transmissions. Tempest is a bit easier. And yes, we're aware that the enemy could eavesdrop on our radio conversations, even if they're encrypted, on our telephone conversations, you can tap into phone lines. But believe it or not, even from the power cables and the data cables coming out the back of your PC, there's a certain amount of electromagnetic energy given off by those cables. And with the right equipment, you can monitor, if nothing else, the keystrokes made on a keypad. That can be sucked up from those. So if the KGB cleaner in the corridor has got the right kit, maybe they can monitor what you're doing. So the Tempest kit is supposed to work against that kind of emissions eavesdropping threat.
It's crazy. Mad, isn't it? It's all metal, isn't it?
Yeah, that's just said that. I'm used to it all being concrete.
Yeah.
It's all metal. You just have to put there the arrow that says repair.
Sounds great.
Oh, yeah.
The arrows?
Oh, they glanded up.
Air handling, controls, the air handling, as well. Again, you can see the US Marine Corps have been busy in here. You've got a small office in one corner there with a proper door to the right, and then a sledgehammer door to the left, where again they've been practicing their
bridge. Why don't they just go over the wall?
Mm.
Right, we're going to make our way back into the main corridor.
See the vents. Asbestos. Mm. Wow, look at that.
I thought you just lighted
it up. It's out for everyone, isn't it?
Yes, everyone.
Seen 208 volts before.
Well, I haven't seen that before, no. Crazy, isn't it?
Places where we do have some room signs indicating what the room might have been used for. So to get into this room, you would have had a combination lock on here. Again, the Marine Corps sledgehammers have dealt with it. You can still see where the tumbler combination lock, like you have on a safe, would mean you'd not just have a key, but also have to have the combination to get into this room. Big metal door. You can see again the sledgehammers of the Marines kind of batter their way in, practicing those breaching techniques. Now in here, once you've locked yourself in the room, if anyone else wants to come in, there's an intercom and you can then say, right, can I come in, Bob? No, I've got to put away all the codes first, and then you can come in. Probably not codes as such, but certainly planning documents, because you can see here it still says ECJ5 staff. EC stands for European Command, because the 1980s bunker had a twofold purpose. The main purpose was to be the United States Air Force's headquarters for the European theatre of operations. So any Air Force operation throughout Europe in World War III, they're all commanded from this location.
Hmm. Might as well.
Whoops.
What's my new coat? The old vents.
This is the old newspaper as well.
Where's that?
Over there.
Oh, yeah, look at this.
Special effects something cartridges.
They said it was a film company that used at some point, so
yeah.
Got to get good. The room's a good smell.
Mm. Lovely.
Right, I think that's done there.
Yeah, that'll be. How are we doing?
Not too bad.
Around the corner, John?
Yep, that's still in there. They're still in there.
Okay, so again, more signs on the door here. This is where the director of ECJ2 would live, so the director of intelligence. So European Command, the intelligence director is in here, and specifically his planning cell, so these are intelligence plans, as opposed to the operational planning that we saw in the previous room there. Another more inexplicable piece of kit. It is the Erga 220 infrared gas analyzer.
You got one of those?
Got it on eBay, didn't you? Yeah. It looks to have been added later on. It's just a hole in the ceiling where they've jammed some cables through. It doesn't look particularly permanent or intended in place here. What an Erga 220 infrared gas analyzer does.
Still got the keys in there.
Still got the keys. Don't touch it. We'll turn on. Again, why that's been plonked here in what seems to have been an intelligence planning cell, I don't know. Again, why it was left behind when virtually everything else was stripped out, that we don't know either.
Massive rooms, aren't they? Oh, yeah. It's bad, isn't it?
When we get up here, we're going straight ahead into the one classroom that is in the operation.
Refrigeration gas warning.
Weird, isn't it? The speaker system.
Yeah.
Red lock, look at that, it's working, folks. Madness.
Turn light off.
Oh yeah. That's better. See that, Chris?
Yeah. You ready?
Amazing.
What'd you
do? Not the plan.
That's interfering.
What's that?
See, hydraulic rams. This opens and can lower plant.
Oh, alright.
So you'll see one of these in this location on each floor.
Oh, top, yeah, I see. Yeah,
so
yeah,
they
yeah.
open up and they can lower it down. So when we go up, we'll
have to see. What is that? Hydraulic rams.
That's mad, isn't it?
Not that it's in. Oh, it's got a dark arrow, then.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. Glowing in the dark.
Top mark on the wall.
Radiation. Cool, hot now. There's the bottom of that plate. Yeah. Lifts up.
One above it as well.
How mad is that? Yeah, Chris has said.
So this is fold up a lot. It's yeah. locking lock yeah. into place here. The same amount we put off.
Mad, isn't it? It's a proper different bunker compared to the other ones.
Yeah, that's good. What's that for then?
I think it's a bit of a lower and stuff in there now.
Through there.
Oh, through here.
So that's the only plant room that is actually within the operational space of the bunker, all the air handling units.
Thank you.
So turn right immediately.
Okay.
Come out
of
the door where I was.
Wow.
Yeah, this is good.
It's like Concord.
So I can only assume that the reason this isn't in that plant void is because someone's sitting here and it's just too big to fit in there.
Look at the colour lights, lovely, isn't it? Like Christmas.
Don't trip over the corner there.
Head. Yeah, it's alright, mate, it's alright. Sat. There you go, you go inside there.
Was located on Dawes Hill, and they acquired the base coming out permission to use the spooky bunker for spooky Halloween parties for 100 years.
Shocking, isn't it? It's graffiti.
Certain school kids had a Halloween party and they were allowed to decorate.
Oh. But not that.
That's just safety room in there.
Of staff, you needed an overarching command system of computers and communications that meant it would hopefully take minutes rather than hours for warning information to go to the White House, decisions to be made, and then the orders to be given back out to the forces.
What rooms look the same?
Cuban Missile Crisis is the case in point. It's probably the closest that World War III ever came to turning nuclear. But of course, if you remember, Khrushchev wanted to install short-range nuclear missiles in the Caribbean island of Cuba. The Americans weren't happy with that on their doorstep. And so they put a naval embargo around the island of Cuba, and the Russians were going to steam full speed ahead and break that.
Above ground classified storage.
And the Americans opened fire on ships carrying nuclear weapons, who knows what would happen. Luckily, the Russians backed down on that one. But that's when WIMIX was installed, to try and ensure that if ever there was a future situation like that, the other side would take minutes rather than hours
for
that information to go up the chain and back down the chain as well. Did it work? There's a lot of supposedly all singing and dancing integrated IT systems, really. Its first test came in 1967, when the Six-Day War took place in the Middle East, Israel fighting its neighbours, Egypt, Syria, etc. And whilst the Americans weren't overtly involved, they did have an eavesdropping electronic warfare ship, the USS Liberty, steaming off the coast of Israel, listening in and hoovering up all the electronic information from both sides. The Chiefs of Staff thought the ship was getting too close, fighting, and no less than five priority messages were sent to the ship to order it to pull back from the coast. The first of those messages reached the ship 13 hours after it had been sent from Annapolis stateside. By then it was too late. The Israelis had seen the ship. They'd incorrectly identified it.
It's focused, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't they mind knocking down? Wasn't that the usual
one? I heard something like that. Another room there.
We're going to have to miss a few bits out. Just try and keep them all together, I think.
Look at that, there's a smoke sensor. Classic one, that.
Do you know what? I would absolutely love to stay in my family.
Yeah, I'd spend 24 hours, 48 hours filming it. Maybe more. Crazy, folks. What's in there?
Oh, yes. There's glass everywhere.
Bloody hell. Works in.
It's not there as well.
It's a bit weird being in the metal box though. Very strange.
So those are plugs.
In the 1980s, all these walls were put in place to create different spaces. And certainly they were...
I'm not an expert on networking. I believe these... Oh, yeah, WWM and CCS.
The printers.
Old network terminals.
Oh, yeah.
Man.
Probably mouldy. Bit mouldy in it.
Color and to give you an idea of what it was like in the bunker. I've got some anecdotes and some veteran reminiscences. Actually, those photographs, definitely wartime. Probably the job to look at the aircraft images. They've taken over enemy lines and say, yes, these were tracks of time. Just see peeking out from that bush, a fuel tank, a V2 rocket supply system. Yes, we think this is a V2 rocket sighting. Interpret all that information. We've got General Spatz, the Commander of Strategic Air Forces in Europe, sat there with the glasses, next to him, Duke Commander of the Mugger. And that picture was taken on the 27th of July, 1943. It's the first American service women over in mid-1943. Amongst them, you have the switchboard girls. By the looks on the faces of the officers and by their activities. So that's an indication of the work here in the operations room. As I say, in the early Cold War, 1950s and 60s, before the Reagan refit, they were working with the same kind of bunker and the same technology. So a big two-story operations room, just like that picture from 1976, that's going around on the
Fire exit.
What's in there?
Broken ceiling plugs.
Oh, nice. What's that?
It's a closet. That's what that is.
That's a fire hydrant.
Oh wow.
Look at that. What's in there?
Mad door, isn't it?
Look at that. Good
one. Yeah.
Right, so we're now on the third floor, which you can actually stand here and pretty much see all four walls of the bunker. So this is the smallest floor of the three. Around the bottom floor being the biggest, level two where we've just come from being the medium-sized one, and this is the smallest one. And for the 1980s bunker, this was the integrated communications facility. So this was where all of the communications, whether it be through
Seals.
Teletype, telex, high-frequency radio, landlines, it would all have come to the communications nerve centre here on this level, being decrypted. If necessary, you phone people and tell them what the message contains. You might print it out, put it in an envelope, give it to a courier, and he would run up to the base up above, or even jump on a motorbike and zip down to RAF Fairford or whatever to deliver that sensitive message. Now, in the earlier Cold War, the communication facility was probably downstairs, because again, I've got another quote, in this case from a chap called Bob Muir, who worked in the bunker from 1962 to 1964. He says, I was with the 485th Communications Squadron, 7th Air Division Headquarters at High Wycombe Air Station.
I worked as the radio operator at the start of my tour there and had voice contact with the Strategic Air Command Airborne Command Post.
While he's talking, I'm not going to.
Wow.
My job in the bunker was as a technical controller, maintaining the turntype and landline circuit.
Where's your head on that? Look at the back of the door.
Cosmetic custodian.
Oh wow.
That's a picture opportunity.
We'd not get lost though, don't we? Oh, I don't care, well, sorry.
Right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bigger than I thought.
It is. Weird one, isn't it? Did everyone look round at me when I was down?
Yeah.
So
that has got to be gas detection. You know.
Yeah.
Right, there's another room the other end. I need to go back into the main room going on.
What about this one?
I don't know. I think you're
open that hole, it's big in there.
You're wandering off a bit there, look.
Go. Come. Look at this. That's old, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's the corridor there.
That's why we're going along, so we'll go back round. Maybe we should wander off too far.
Printers.
Doors up and down the length of the bunker. Once we're through the blast doors, you look to your right, the black void dropping away is that emergency exit ladder that we saw the bottom of when we were making our walk around the bronze corridor.
That is, nice, that, isn't it? We've already been in there.
But not that way. We went that way.
Look at that intercom there.
What's that name?
Is it? Look at the light above you.
It's a speaker, isn't it?
There.
They're not. That's what they're doing in there. They are putting lighting in.
Oh, right, so it's just the room? Sorry, put the mask on, mate.
No. Tell us how they're heading that. They're in the process of doing lighting. No, I reckon they're still doing lighting. It's a lot of cables.
Have we been in here? Oh, look at this!
That seems like there's too much for us to be showing here.
They look like 1950s stuff. Go and pop it open.
I need to go back. Good. So much. Hatch further down, so you have a crane up to three levels.
So this is the top of that?
Yeah, that's what's it, go down on three.
One door, second door, and the ground door.
Right.
So there's only two doors.
Right.
So you look this one, only the second one, and you get stuff on the back.
Which
prong here. You can either take down into the prong void, or you can open up the glass door and transfer it from here.
It's like the green and common one.
Yeah, it's like the level. It is hollow, it's hollow. It's
what we got here?
That's that void that goes down to the plant.
Oh,
this
yeah.
This is a plant void, so you can see all the way to the bottom.
Yeah, we'll see what that
thing
looks
up
like.
There, an alarm or... Oh no, so is it a hoist thing?
Yeah, it's to do with the hoist cable.
Because it's to make sure the hoist is parked out of the way of the shaded area, or else the door wouldn't shut.
Right.
So you've got a crane, you bring it in, the crane is alarmed.
Whoops. Oh, is this the track she was on about?
Yeah. Oh, right.
So it's like Langdon Hole. Oh yeah. Well, step away from it, please, Chris.
What?
So get a shot of that. Thanks.
You mean get out of line?
Step aside.
Step away.
Step aside. That's in better days, isn't it?
Yeah.
Easy, folk. Oh yeah, cheers, yeah.